And there was a conservative writer on the panel, of course, and he was sitting to the far left of the camera, very telling. And he's one of these, like, Chamber of Commerce type, who has accepted and welcomes the supposed inevitability of this basically becoming North Mexico, and that the Latino vote is somebody who has to be cultivated.
Was he pronouncing it like that?
No, he didn't, but somebody else.
Anybody that pronounces it like that, I'm punch in the face.
I was doing that because I knew it would trigger you. Latino. But yeah, it was like, he was like,
ball, man.
And that the conclusion of the clip came around, you know, when he was asking Coulter, who would she want when Trump gets run out of town? Because obviously, and you know, she said Romney. She likes Romney, and I can't remember who she said. And she was just going on and on with it. And the question came down. She said something about, like, Romney got, she said the percentage of the white vote. And she said with 4 more percentage points worth of the white vote, he would be president. And of course, this was taken as a cue for Bill Maher to make a show. Like, oh, yes, the only thing wrong with Mitt Romney was he needed to be a little bit whiter. And, like, that's the end of the segment. But
predictable.
That's what I have for Bill Maher.
But there it is. But there's the established narrative that we have to accept that this Hispanic demographic is going to grow and grow and grow, and it's going to overtake us. And and the Republican side, whatever the opposition party is to the Democrats, has to work, Goyim, to get some of these taco benders on your side, or else you're just gonna be twisting in the wind and on the outside looking in. I don't know what you're gonna do.
Maddening that, like, the only necessary response to saying, like, if we just had, like, 4% more whites than Romney would have won, is to just mock the idea
that, when
white,
really
that
all
whiter
you,
would be better.
Right. You need
that more white people would be better.
You need a few,
oh, you want more white people. You must be.
It's not even you wanted more white people. It's you want a few fewer white cucks to wake up and realize what the fuck's going on.
Or you want the relative representation on whites down. And the other thing is, and the one thing I wanted to get to was that this conservative I had been arguing with on NRO said something like, even if I agreed with you that it was optimal for the United States to maintain and keep a white majority, like, basically the cat's out of the bag, like, it can't possibly be reversed. She said something like, I'm gonna say she, because the avatar was a woman, so probably some weeb. But they could have
this is waifu,
but yeah, whatever, it doesn't matter. But so this woman was saying, like, it's just it would be impossible to deport everybody now. And I'm like, first of all, it wouldn't be. And second of all, you don't have to deport all of them.
No.
If you remove incentives for them to stay, they'll go away.
Exactly. You make them want to leave.
And if you're in a hole, stop digging.
Yeah. If you remove sanctuary cities, if you say that any employee of any social service agency has to inquire about and report the immigration status of anyone seeking aid, if people coming to the emergency room, they can get treatment, but if they don't show proof of citizenship, whether it be a driver's license or a passport or something, at some point they're going to get deported after they receive treatment. You know, things like this. If you started putting things like this in place, people would start going away.
Yep, it's a simple thing. It took,
if you put the word out that if you hire them, you're going to get fucked.
See, the problem,
I know that triggers libertarians. But I don't care.
I don't care either. That's the thing. Like, people don't realize the massive change in mentality and change in policy that 1965 was. I mean, I know. Granted, that most stuff we're talking about is laws on the books not being enforced, but this went along with having that law passed in 65. It's taken 40 years.
If laws had been enforced, we'd be in a much better position than we are now.
But that's the mentality, and the mentality has gone this way for 40 years unchecked, and this is where we are now. And you can have. You can create a change in policy, a change in mentality, and 40 years from now, none of them want to be here. And you know, it just trickle. It'll take 40 years to turn the trend around. You turn the trend around. Everything's about trends.
We could turn this around. Look, this has happened in the last 50 years. It could be turned around.
50 years seems like
a long time, but doable if the will and the policies are there. We can, and you don't have to do anything. There's some violence would be required, but less than people think. I mean,
right.
With the Mexicans and the illegals, we could. easily disincentivize them being here with some few simple changes.
And this like, was, oh, I should mention.
Shit. They don't get shit for free. They can't send their kids to school. They can't go to the hospital
right,
and get treatment. They'll get treatment. I'm not saying refuse people that are that need treatment treatment. I'm just saying
you hold them.
It's unethical. Doctors have to provide it. But the afterwards, they're going back home.
They're going home.
And then, you know, like, you know, you want to get welfare, you're not going to get it. And if you go and ask at the office, they're going to ask for your status. And if you're not, if you know, if you're not a citizen, you're going to detention, and you're going back to Mexico, or you're going back to Guatemala, or wherever the fuck.
And
you
I
know, like any number of things. If it was just known that they can't receive any services, they will be gone.
They'll be gone because there's no reason to come
as
here.
As much as they're here to work hard,
they
one
don't.
Member of the family is here to work hard, and the rest of them. And he's here to work hard doing shit like spackling walls and mowing lawns.
Hey.
He's not here to do like fucking invent the new Google or some shit.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right. And
well, even if they are here to work, you know, you make e-verify non-optional and then punish firms if they violate it.
Right, exactly.
They can't work here anyway.
Right. And there's this guy, I wish, I should have just grabbed the soundbite, but I didn't have, I just didn't have the initiative to, for, at that moment. But in the Bill Maher panel, the guy who pronounced it Latino, he actually said that, like, one of the things about it was like, it's, you know, we need assimilation. We have all these people here, and there's this many thousand people every day, you know, picking vegetables in the field. And not only, you know, his point was not only should they be here, but we can pay them a living wage to do this work. It's like so the left not only want the left want
planets.
Right, the left wants them to, the left wants them to stay, and they also want to give them a raise. I mean, that negates the whole purpose of them being here.
Yeah, I know. That's
the whole reason they're here is because
the news today. If you just looked in the news today, Jerry Brown is saying, governor of California is saying, illegal, legal, doesn't matter. We want you in California. You're welcome here. We'll give you a driver's license. We'll give you everything.
Of course.
Jerry Brown is just a traitor.
There's nothing you can do about Jerry Brown now because L.A., Sacramento, and San Francisco just outvote all the good people in that state. Because there are good people in that state.
You know the thing they say about San Francisco?
Never seen something more craven in my entire life.
You know what they say about San Francisco?
It's the greatest gay market in the world.
But no, that aside, the funny thing about San Francisco.
You know what I say about San Francisco?
What's that?
Go eat a sausage and choke on it.
Yo, I'm gay.
You should only get AIDS and die, you pig.
I'm gay.
This is gay.
Those are my favorite drops. I just walk around saying to myself, I'm gay. This is gay.
I'm gay.
I say that to myself.
Football is gay.
I love that.
Everybody got somebody gay in their house.
All right. Sorry. Sorry. Enough.